Welcome back to That Dad Guy. It's September the 5th, 2023. I've extended my vacation by one more day. I'm going to be using it for postcard writing. Reason why my car was still in the shop. I had it fixed while I was away, and so I didn't have it to use for work today. But that's okay. My body is still saying I need to be on vacation. And luckily, I've had a bunch of my cards reach their destinations for official post-crossing. So I have 11 cards that I can send out. So I'm going to show you the ones that I picked for that. I've also been very blessed to have a bunch of people send me mail this past week. So I've got some direct swaps. I'm going to show you what I've chosen to go out. And yeah, then tomorrow, I am hoping that I'm going to show you some of the postcards that I bought while I was away on vacation. And I'm also going to introduce you to my World Postcard Day card that I've designed that's going out this year. I know other friends of mine are already starting to show what they've designed and are sending out this year. So that's good. You have to go check out Renee Lewis's card on her latest video that came out. And Snail Mail with Smokey 2 has put out a card and has revealed it. My reveal is coming soon, so stay tuned. All right, feel free to subscribe. I really wish you would. And like, leave me positive comments, and share with other people. So that's why we're making this channel grow. All right, let's get into it. The first card that I have going out is going to Pennsylvania in the United States. She says she's married. She has adult children, has 3 grandchildren now. She's a veteran of the U.S. Air Force. Thank you so much for your service. Her hobbies include sewing, embroidery, cross-stitching, reading, antiquing, and metal detecting. She also enjoys anything paper, stationery, or washi tape, stickers, mail art, ephemera, and stamps, which means she loves writing letters and postcards. Her favorite author is Stephen King, and she believes she has every book he's ever written. She loves all kinds of music, especially Janis Joplin and Sam Cooke. Halloween's her favorite holiday. She loves anything spooky, creepy, or haunted. Things that she enjoys to read or to receive as cards are greetings from ghosts, tarot, bats, haunted houses, abandoned places, vintage circus, freak shows, apothecary, pharmacies, peony flowers, ravens, the number 13, glass blown, larking, Mudfield Beach, old movie monster posters, tombstones, cemeteries, and goes on and on. And it's just like, know anything about you, squeeze as many words as you can onto the postcard. I hope you will do the same, because that's what she does. All right, I've chosen this recent one that I've got, the Ringling Brothers. I really like this. It has all the creepy clown faces on there, so I thought maybe she would like it. She likes circus cards and things. Hadn't had circus cards until then, so I'm glad to send it right out. All right, the next card is going off to Germany, and she says she lives in Dusseldorf, and she loves reading books, yoga, horses, and photography, nature, landscapes, animals. She's not really a good photographer herself, though, she says, but she likes seeing it. Every day, she's very curious about finding what's in her mailbox. She's happy with every card that is sent. There are lots of such interesting cards. She loves them all. But if you need some inspiration, I like postcards with birds, cats, owls, bicycles, flowers, poppies, horses, natures, and landscape. Not only photographs, but also paintings, art, Art Nouveau, funny and romantic cards, as well as maxi cards or post-related stamps, mailboxes, postmen. So you can have a look into my favorites as well for inspiration. If you stick beautiful stamps on the card, she will really make her day. So that is great. I'm going with this one. She likes birds. Look at all the birds. These are the thousands and thousands of sandpipers that flood the beaches at Hopewell Rocks or in Dorchester, New Brunswick. So there's some nature, there's some birds, and there's a bit of history of the migration that comes this way. All right, next card is off to Japan. Didn't write a lot, but she says she's excited to receive postcards from all around the world and love whatever you choose for her. If you would like to send a message, please write in your language. I'm really looking forward to it. If you like to know some ideas what to send, her interests are art, food culture, cityscapes, and where you are. So I chose where you are. Even though this is Prince Edward Island, that's my region of Canada. And I know that Anna Green Gables is very popular in Japan. So I am betting on this person enjoying a card from Anna Green Gables. Okay. The next card I have, this is the first time I've gotten to write to this country, it's going to Saudi Arabia. The person there is originally from the Philippines, but she's a nurse and she's working in that area. She collects postcards since she was 15. She likes all kinds of postcards, but prefers map cards or flag cards. Bridges, sunsets, stadiums, people, famous landmarks, waterfalls with the name in the front and in a single view. Also collects mini sheets of stamps, first day covers, and banknotes. She's trying to answer all who's to send the cards for direct and private swaps, but please be informed that I'm swapping two cards for each Saudi card. So if you want to trade with this person, she's suggesting you send two cards. And she also says to leave your return address on it. I don't normally put my return address on the postcards because I don't expect anything back on my official ones. I know if people reach out, sometimes they get the card and they say, we'd like to swap back, or I'd like to send you something. Then I send them my address, but generally I don't. This is what I'm sending. She wants flags. So this is the flag of New Brunswick, the province that I live in. I'm betting that she doesn't have this one yet, or I'm hoping she doesn't have that one yet, so she can enjoy it. And I'm very happy to write to Saudi Arabia. That's really cool. All right, next one I have is going off to the United Kingdom. And she was born in 1945, she says. She has a son and a daughter and four grandchildren. She enjoys reading. Her current book is The House of Dudley, author Joanne Paul. Favorite poem is The Church Going by Philip Larkin. Other favorite is Dover Beach by Matthew Arnold. And try this poem, Happiness by Raymond Carver. So there's some things that if you want to look up, you can. In November of 1963, she watched the very first episode of Doctor Who when BBC TV launched a series on an unsuspecting world. And she's followed the adventures of Doctor Who more or less over the years. So, right there, I stopped. She's getting a Doctor Who postcard, Exterminate. I might talk about Canada on the back, but whenever I find a Doctor Who lover, I'm going to send them a Doctor Who postcard. It's exciting, and it's something we have in common. All right, next one is going to Germany. And she lives on the Baltic Sea in northern Germany. She really loves the sea. She's a mother of two children. Together as a family, they go sailing. They really enjoy nature, wide skies, freedom. And all through the year, they love reading, coffee, being together with good friends. They love postcards you would like to receive. And of course, pictures of the ocean, sailing, books, and also would love homemade postcards. So what's the sea? Here is a sailing boat, Nova Scotia, the water. Yeah, we got lots of that here on the East Coast. All right, moving along. The next card is going to Taiwan. She says she loves traveling, movies, contemporary art. When traveling, she'd like to see scenery, visit historic buildings, exhibition, and visit art museums. I have a friend that does that as well. Also like to take risks and challenge exciting outdoor activities. Hope to receive beautiful scenery, architecture, artwork, cultural features from around the world, or you can share your daily life, something special, your country, your culture. She'll enjoy it. So I'm sending this prepaid postcard. She didn't say anything about collecting stamps, and we have these beautiful icebergs in Newfoundland, so I thought maybe she'd enjoy the scenery. Also might not be something that she has there. Okay, next card is going to Washington State. She says she's a retired high school teacher who loves cats, crafts, reading, and especially history. Her husband and I have spent many years living in Canada as well as in Alaska. Would enjoy hearing from those who love life as much as I do. Especially tell me about where you live, something about your country's history, famous landmarks. Do you have any pets, hobbies, or anything else that interests you? For those of you who like more direction, I like scenery cards, historical landmarks, cats, native people to your area and culture. And anything you choose to send will be welcome. I also enjoy creative people, so handmade cards are welcome. She prefers 4x6 postcards. I'm assuming that's how she stores them, so these big long ones aren't good for her. Furthermore, for fun, thunderstorms, shades of pale pink and dark rose make me laugh. Flowers, coffee, blue cat, Ingluck. And so I've chosen nature from this area. She wanted that. She wanted history. So there's a bit of history for the Hopewell Rocks on the back. And it's something from the East Coast. So she may have been in Canada, but she didn't say she was on the eastern part of Canada. So let's send that. All right. Next one is going to Germany again. And she says her passions are pen palling, post-crossing, and playing classical guitar. She also likes cooking, knitting, gardening. She loves to have her own fruits and vegetables, playing the French horn. Her favorite flowers are sunflowers. And in the summer, she also enjoys her garden. One day she'd love to live in an old castle or lighthouse. She says, will she do it? Probably not, but it's a dream. Another dream is to travel the transit, the Orient Express, the train around Canada and the United States. Her favorite colors are yellow and blue. She goes on to do a bunch of really cool things. She also writes out the word post-crossing and then writes out things on it that she would like P is for picture of a card, O is for content of text, but she has the O in the context of the O. So she takes some liberties in trying to get it. I went with this nice lighthouse here in New Brunswick. That maybe that's a place she wants to live one day. I don't know. All right. The next card is going to Finland. And she says she lives in the countryside in the north of Finland. She's interested in art, paintings, music, handicrafts, and history. She loves sending to receive cards from all around the world. She would like to receive postcards, no multi-views, no envelopes, cards, like blue cat cards, cows, cats, birds, butterflies, fish, wild animals from your country, painted art, landscapes of your country, Grand Canyon, Niagara Falls, Mount Rushmore, something which your country is known about, underwater world, plants, trees, colorful flowers, fields, farm life, people at work, black and white old photos. Anyways, every card is welcome. And then please write something on your card. Your message will make it extra special. She said Niagara Falls. We've got Niagara Falls here in Canada, so let's send you that postcard. All right, one more, my last official one that I have to write up to send, and it's also going to Germany. And she says she's 63 years old. She lives near Hanover. Her profession is to sell books, so no surprise, she loves to read books. Her hometown is a little, manageable town situated in the so-called Kahlenberger land, surrounded by beautiful landscapes and forests named Deister. Her interests are art, theater, hiking, biking, and yes, books, novels, thrillers, children's books, biographies, and art. There's no special preference in receiving postcards, but thank you in advance. So I've sent this, which is the Waterwheel, the mill at King's Landing here in New Brunswick. There you go. So those are the official postcards I have to tackle to send out, quite a few. Now let me show you the ones that I've picked for my direct swaps. We have this one of the Roosevelt Cottage here on Campobello Island in New Brunswick. So the President of the United States used to have a cottage here in New Brunswick. Did you know? Now you do. The next card is a nice sailboat in Dartmouth, which is right across the water from Halifax in Nova Scotia. Lots of nice lakes and things in that area. Here's a did you know about lighthouses here on the East Coast. After returning from Montreal, I'm going to send out some Montreal postcards too. So that one and that one, my extra long ones. I didn't buy any more extra long ones this trip. I do have quite a few from that my daughter bought me last time, so I didn't feel I needed to buy a bunch just yet. Then this extra long one of the Montmorency Falls where we went, and Ari took and I took the tram back up. We took the stairs down and then trammed it back to the top again. I am sending a wooden postcard. And this is Santa Monica Zombie Apocalypse. That's kind of a cool postcard. These came from Ross, sent them to me, and now they're going back out again. Great to collect them, but when they're blank, they're for sending, not for saving. This one here of Montreal. Some things to do in the summer. This one here of some dolls. A doll in a wedding dress. This one here of Hopewell Rocks, where the flower pots are. I sent lots of postcards from there, but this is another nice view. You can see the tides way out and you got the muddy silt on the ground. This one here, there's a Russian fairy tale postcard and originally came from Yulia. She sent me a book with the fairy tale, and actually at one point in time went through the fairy tale and talked about the whole thing in a video. So you can go back and find that if you're interested. This one here, cartoon of Star Wars. So there you have Rey. Another wooden postcard heading out. Another Santa Monica one. really cool. And then last but not least, one of my That Dad Guy postcards is going out this time around as well. So, with 25 postcards to write, I better get at it. And then tomorrow, I'm hoping, stay tuned, and you can see the reveal of the postcards that I've got for World Postcard Day, plus any postcards that I bought while I was away. I'll show you those too. All right, have a magical week.
Like, follow, you say. Like, subscribe, share, and tell all your friends.
Who's a good boy? Who's a good boy?
Bye.